Hello, my name is Catherine Ling, and I'm an associate professor here at the Johns Hopkins University School of Nursing. I've had the great good fortune to be a family nurse practitioner in active practice since 1993. My scholarship, which encompasses all of my teaching, my wellness practice with our community nursing center, global practicums work, as well as service, all has a similar theme in that I'm working to increase access to quality primary care. You increase access to care by making sure that you have the best prepared providers available across the country in places where they may not have been found before, by making sure that our science and our evidence is up to date and is being disseminated, as well as we're creating an inclusive space. Primary care is where an individual can consistently access healthcare. That point where they enter the healthcare system is where they are choosing to get their primary care. Some folks use urgent care centers. Some have a traditional provider in an office that they see on a regular basis, but we're also finding primary care be delivered in different types of platforms than we saw really before the pandemic. So policy really does need to continue to build bridges and create those points of access and continuity that individuals need to care for their health. The one population that I continually focus on is military families. They are not necessarily the top of some folks' list of a vulnerable population because they do have routine access to health care. However, there are several challenges associated with the culture of being in a military family that create barriers to care and longevity and continuity. And so as we begin to create the best science to take care of individuals and create access to primary care, making sure that even populations that at first glance don't appear to be vulnerable, we are culturally tailoring access and opportunity is really critical.